Annyeong Haseyo, Yeoreobun. Je ireumun Tanisha-imnida. Today, I'm going to cook bibimbap naengmyeon, which is spicy Korean cold noodles. And it is a variant of mul naengmyeon Korean cold noodles. And if you're wondering why someone would like to eat cold noodles in winters, then let me tell you why.
In old times, during summers, there was no ice available. So, people used to wait for winters to enjoy cold noodles. It was like beating cold with cold. They used to put all ingredients in an earthen pot and keep it outside so it gets cold naturally. But now, we all have this lovely thing in our homes. We can enjoy cold noodles at any time of the year. There are many variants of cold noodles now, but mul naengmyeon and bibimbap naengmyeon are basic versions. Also, do you know that cold noodles were first recorded during Joseon Dynasty era? Now, let's move on to the recipe. Please note that this is a vegetarian version of original and suggested according to Indian palate, and also due to lack of availability of certain authentic ingredients. Saucepan, add sugar and melt it completely. Then add water and mix until no lumps are left. Now add gochugaru. I made it by combining half part of degi mirch and half part of Kashmiri mirch. At last, add sesame oil and your gochujang is ready. Take a radish and thinly slice them, then transfer them to a bowl and add in sea salt. Mix well, then cover it and keep it aside for 30 minutes. I have already drained out excess water and washed it to remove excess salt. Now add vinegar, sugar and steep in gochugaru really nicely. Combine all the ingredients well, then cover it and leave it for at least 3 hours. I suggest you to keep it overnight before use as it gets more savory. Add onion, apple, garlic, gochujang, gochugaru, sugar, sesame seeds, and a pinch of salt. Blend all well. After blending, check for any leftover lumps, then add soya sauce and sesame oil, and again blend well. Your bibimbap sauce is ready. Take a deep bowl and add your noodles, or you can mix them with prepared sauce before plating. Then add prepared sauce according to how spicy you like it. Add cucumber, apples, vegetable broth, sesame seeds and green onion greens. Now you can serve them cold along with pickled radish we made earlier. I added few more Korean side dishes like sesame oil spinach, baked mushrooms and jumokbap or fished rice. All of these goes really well with these spicy noodles. So you can now enjoy them as your lunch or dinner. Thank you.